evening I was told to go 1 hour. I don't like to preach that long, but the Spirit told me to go on. I had to go on. Can you say amen?
Amen.
When I preach long, don't blame me. Blame the authorities above that tell me to speak. What book did I say? What chapter? What verse? 24. Read it with me. God is a spirit. And they that worship him, what's the next word? Scoff. What do you understand by must? You should. Someone said you should. No compulsory. Go on. No option. Go on. Someone from this side. It's not a request. It's not a request. You don't find the word please behind must or in front of it. They that worship him must. Now, we don't like to be told what to do. That's where the carnal nature is. But this verse would tell us, we must worship him how? In spirit, son. Most people have no problem worshiping God in spirit. Although they worship him in the wrong spirit. Because Jesus calls the spirit of the truth. Listen to John 16:13. Howbeit, when he, the spirit in truth, is come. John 14:16, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth. So that, if you have the right Spirit, that Spirit will lead you to what? To truth. You cannot fight truth while you have the Spirit of truth. Let me say it again. If you're fighting the truth, it is not the spirit of truth that's in you. Always remember there are two spirits. There are two kingdoms. There are two kings. And there are two outcomes. And so Jesus, the one you love, God is a spirit. And they that worship him must worship him. In spirit and in truth. In verse 23, the end of that verse says, for the Father seeketh such to worship him. In other words, God is looking for people who will worship him in spirit and in truth, or in the spirit of truth. We live in a world where people, as I said sometime last week, confuse noise with the spirit of God. They confuse dancing with the Spirit of God. They confuse loud talking in tongues with the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God is found where the truth of God is lifted up. Can you say amen?
Amen.
The God of worship. We discovered this morning, we summarize for the final time. Isaiah 6:3, the whole earth, finish the verse, is full of the story. Psalm 19:1, say that verse. The heavens declare the glory of God. Romans 1:20, for the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made. The invisible things, his characteristics. We've discovered that Jesus Christ, by the identification of the Father, is the one who actually carried out creation, but at the request of the Father. So the characteristics of our Savior are found in nature. But since Jesus is just like the Father, the characteristics of Christ are the characteristics of the Father. The Father, the Son, they appeal to creation to defend their role as divine beings. Because false gods cannot create. And the highest of all false gods is Satan. He was created. You discovered that creation is the reason why we worship God. In other words, worship is acknowledging that you, dear God, are the creator. And I accept the memorial you've given to me, which is a seven-day Sabbath, which you blessed and you've asked me to observe it as evidence that I recognize you as creator. Let me be even more harsh. When I recognize another day, I do not recognize God. How can I say this? A lot of people think they're worshiping God, but they're worshiping the devil. Now, that can change. You can move from that condition to a true worship of God. Because the Bible says God is looking for people. They are in the wrong system. He's looking for them to pull them into the right system.
Amen.
In Matthew 12 from verse 25, Matthew 12 from verse 22, and there was brought unto him a man possessed of the devil, blind and dumb, and he healed him, insomuch that the blind and dumb both spake and saw. In that act of healing, Jesus took a man from demon possession, living in Satan's kingdom, to God's kingdom. That's when I say there are people not worshiping God, but thinking they are. You can move from that state to the right state just by an acceptance and a surrender to God.
Amen.
The Father seeketh such to worship Him. If God is looking for people to worship Him in spirit and in truth, can He find you? He's looking now. The eyes of the Lord are where? In every place. God is looking now. As He looks at you, can He tell the angels, that woman will follow me? She just didn't know. As He looks at you, can He say, that man has a sincere heart? He did not realize he was in error. That young man has a heart for me, but he's under pressure from his family. That's why he goes to church on Sunday. The Father seeketh such. And that search is going on now. Since you know God is searching, you know there's a game show in the United States called The Price is Right. And they give away a lot of things. And the place is full of people, the audience, they dress in all kinds of ways because they want to be chosen by the host to come up and try to win a car or a house or vacation to a Uganda or something. And so they dress in ways to attract attention. Some people dress as a skeleton, some dress as a scarecrow, some dress as a bumblebee. Now, since you know God is looking for those who would worship Him, how? In spirit. What are you doing to make sure God sees you? In other words, you're saying, here am I. Father, you're looking. Here am I. If you're a teacher, you know the eager students in the classroom. When did Columbus sail the ocean blue? 1492. What am I saying? Raise your hand to God in your heart and say, Father, you're looking? Here.
Amen.
I want to worship you in spirit and in truth. In the new world, all flesh shall come to worship God. And they'll worship on the same Sabbath day. Isaiah 66, verse 23. But let me tell you something very sweet. I told you Jesus created. But Jesus is both man and God. Now as man, follow me closely, Jesus has to worship. You're not with me. When Jesus rose from the grave, John 20, what did He tell Mary Magdalene? Go and tell Peter, I have sent to my Father and your Father and to my God and your Lord. In His humanity, did Jesus pray to God? Yes. So here's something that may tantalize you. That's why I give it to you. In the new world, as we worship, Christ in His humanity may join us in worship.